Atenolol is a synthetic beta-1 selective blocker used in the management of hypertension and chronic angina, and to reduce mortality in known or suspected myocardial infarction in hemodynamically stable patients. In this video, let's find found. What is Atenolol? What is Atenolol used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking Atenolol? How does Atenolol work? How to use Atenolol? What is Atenolol? Atenolol is a beta blocker medication primarily used to treat high blood pressure and heart-associated chest pain. Atenolol, however, does not seem to improve mortality in those with high blood pressure. Other uses include the prevention of migraines and treatment of certain irregular heartbeats. Atenolol was patented in 1969 and approved for medical use in 1975. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 53rd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 12 million prescriptions. What is Atenolol used for? Indicated for 1. Management of hypertension alone and in combination with other antihypertensives. 2. Management of angina pectoris associated with coronary atherosclerosis. 3. Management of acute myocardial infarction in hemodynamically stable patients with a heart rate greater than 50 beats per minute and a systolic blood pressure above 100 millimeters of mercury. Off-label uses include 1. Secondary prevention of myocardial infarction. 2. Management of heart failure. 3. Management of atrial fibrillation. 4. Management of supraventricular tachycardia. 5. Management of ventricular arrhythmias such as congenital long QT and arrhythmogenic right ventricular cardiomyopathy. 6. Management of symptomatic thyrotoxicosis in combination with methimazole. 7. Prophylaxis of migraine headaches. 8. Management of alcohol withdrawal. Contraindication. Atenolol is contraindicated in the following patients: asthma, kidney disease, diabetes or low blood glucose, uncontrolled heart failure or heart block, pregnant, could be pregnant, planning to become pregnant or breastfeeding, Raynaud's disease. Side effects. Atenolol use can result in blurred vision, cold hands or feet, difficult or labored breathing, dizziness, faintness, or lightheadedness when getting up from a lying or sitting position suddenly, sweating, tightness in chest, unusual tiredness or weakness, wheezing. Pharmacodynamic. Atenolol is a cardioselective beta blocker and as such exerts most of its effects on the heart. It acts as an antagonist to sympathetic innervation and prevents increases in heart rate, electrical conductivity, and contractility in the heart due to increased release of norepinephrine from the peripheral nervous system. Together, the decreases in contractility and rate produce a reduction in cardiac output, resulting in a compensatory increase in peripheral vascular resistance in the short term. This response later declines to baseline with long-term use of Atenolol. More importantly, this reduction in the work demanded of the myocardium also reduces oxygen demand, which provides therapeutic benefit by reducing the mismatch of oxygen supply and demand in settings where coronary blood flow is limited, such as in coronary atherosclerosis. The effects of Atenolol on blood pressure have been established, although it is less effective than alternative beta blockers, but the mechanism has not yet been characterized. Unlike some other beta-blocker drugs, Atenolol does not have intrinsic sympathomimetic or membrane-stabilizing activity, nor does it produce changes in glycemic control. Mechanism of action. Atenolol is a cardioselective beta-blocker, called such because it selectively binds to the beta-1 adrenergic receptor as an antagonist up to a reported 26-fold more than beta-2 receptors. Selective activity at the beta-1 receptor produces cardioselectivity due to the higher population of this receptor in cardiac tissue. Some binding to beta-2 and possibly beta-3 receptors can still occur at therapeutic dosages, but the effects mediated by antagonizing these are significantly reduced from those of non-selective agents. Beta-1 and beta-2 receptors are GS-coupled, therefore antagonism of their activation reduces activity of adenylyl cyclase and its downstream signaling via cyclic adenosine monophosphate and protein kinase A, pKa. Half-life. The half-life of atenolol is approximately 6 to 7 hours. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. Hypertension. 25 to 50 mg/day PO initially may be increased to 100 mg per day PO. Angina pectoris. 50 mg per day PO after 1 week may be increased to 100 mg per day PO. Some patients may require 200 mg per day. Post-myocardial infarction. Secondary prevention. 100 mg PO once daily or divided Q12HR for 6 to 9 days after myocardial infarction, MI. Alcohol withdrawal syndrome, off-label. 50 to 100 mg/day PO. Supraventricular arrhythmias, off-label. Prevention. 50 mg per day PO, beginning up to 3 days before surgery and continued until 7 days after surgery, may be increased to 100 mg per day. Thyrotoxicosis, off-label. 25 to 100 mg PO once daily or divided Q12HR. Migraine prophylaxis, off-label. 50 mg PO every other day. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category D. There is positive evidence of human fetal risk based on adverse reaction data from investigational or marketing experience or studies in humans, but potential benefits may warrant use of the drug in pregnant women despite potential risks. That's all the information about atenolol we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.